this a dream, or is it reality? Reality, I think. Hello, and welcome to a very special holiday episode of Tea Time. I'm your host, Lauren Ashley Carter, and today we are going to learn how to make latkes. Latkes, for those of you who may not know, are a traditional Jewish dish, a kind of pancake, if you will, made from shredded potatoes, onion, spices, and then shallow fried to a golden crisp. They're fantastic, and we're going to learn how to make them here, now, together. So, you want to start by cleaning and skinning a pound of potatoes. I didn't have a scale, but I figured 4 seemed about right, and I spent the morning skinning and cleaning them. Not necessarily in that order. You want to grate the potatoes into neat little strands, preferably by hand. Hopefully you'll have a better grater than we do. This piece of crap is all we seem to be able to find in the apartment. Be careful, as always, when working in the kitchen. Okay, this is getting ridiculous. Can you please cut? All right, 2. I think 2 will be enough. I think 2 is fine, right? What? Why are you looking at me? You should try to do this. Huh? This grater's garbage. Couldn't cut a goddamn fuck. Are we on? Yeah. Hello? Welcome back. I've taken the liberty of finishing the preparation. I've shredded the potatoes, diced the onion, added some salt and pepper, and lemon zest for flavor. You'll find the recipe below. Just for God's sake, be careful, will ya? Well, all right. Let's go to the kitchen and see how these babies cook up. Now, the recipe I've been following said something about baking these suckers. But that's stupid. Latkes must be fried. Most things should if you want them to taste any good. Now, as you can see, I've heated up a pan of olive oil. You can use corn or canola, if you'd rather. And take one of your shredded potato discs and place them in the skillet. Oh, God! And that is how you make both cheese and blueberry blintz. They look amazing, don't they? Well, let's answer some of those new tea time questions before we dig in. Our first question comes from Facebook, from Peter Bruegel. Hey Lauren, what became of the jug face with your face on it? Did they let you keep it after production? No, they didn't, Peter. And you can talk to Chad Crawford Kinkle about that one. Moving on. Our second question from Facebook, Eric Austin asks, Arthur 2 or Caddyshack 2? I have to answer that question with another movie title, Eric. Grease 2. Another question from Facebook by Amber Navarette. How can you see Sean Spillane's face and just not want to smack it because he's so cute? Well, truth be told, Amber, You can only get arrested for assault so many times before they charge you with a felony. Kyle Myers asks on Facebook, if you could be in any movie ever made, what movie and which character? This is an excellent question, Kyle. Thank you. I would have to say The Baby and Honey, I Blew Up the Kid. Looks like he had a really good time. Our next question also comes from Facebook by Robin Bernard. Who gave you the utmost inspiration in deciding to take up your acting career? Well, Robin, that's a very personal question, but I don't mind talking about it. I would have to say my father, who told me, if you throw enough shit against the wall, something's gotta stick. Next on Facebook, Byron McCoy. What's your favorite scary holiday movie? Well, Byron, that would have to be Black Christmas. Or Home for the Holidays with Holly Hunter. Now moving on to Twitter questions, Jerry1982 asks, what is your current personal list of the most disturbing horror films you can remember? Well, it's quite a long list, Jerry, but off the top of my head, I'd have to say Dahmer and Taxidermia. I never liked cats to begin with. Next on Twitter, C. Powers asks, is there any bad habits you have on camera when working or just in everyday life? Well, C. Powers, I tend to look at lights, like here, and here, and here, when I probably shouldn't, and then I can't see very well. Our next Twitter question comes from Easy H. Makov. Is there will be a second part of Jug Face? Probably not. Unless Ada gets drawn into the mythical land of Fantasia. C. Powers asks, do you use Instagram at all? Hashtag curious. No, hashtag I don't. Well, that's it for today. It's been a long one, but I'm glad we got through it. Have a healthy and happy holiday season. I'm sure I'll see all of you soon, but right now, I'm going to dig into these blints with no remorse. Until next time, don't trust big bearded men in red suits. They almost always have an ulterior motive, and their beards carry mites. Happy Hanukkah and happy Thanksgiving. L'chaim. Was that?